Good evening, California Creek Baptist Church. Hope everybody's doing well on this Wednesday. Hope you can tune in for just a few minutes. If you will, go ahead and get your Bible and pad and paper and pencil pen ready, as we'll be taking some notes tonight as we go through. Really exciting tonight, as we are going to be in the book of Revelation, and we'll be in Revelation chapter 1, verse 9. Again, I want to welcome everybody to Wednesday night Bible study. I hope you've had a great day. I hope you're having a good week, and I hope that your Easter evening went well. And so, as we begin our time together here tonight, let's just always remember to be in prayer for each other, be in prayer for the California Creek community, and remember the seniors that we have in our community. God's protection will be with them and everyone else. A lot going on in our world. Again, there's many updates to the update that keep happening. Every single day, the COVID-19, this is just a fluid situation. But I really appreciate you, church. I love you all so much. You have been generous in your giving to the church. You have been awesome about reaching out through Messenger on Facebook and text messaging and calling each other. Thank you. Thank you so much for what you're doing to love on each other during this time. And I do want to say, if there is a need that you see or you hear about, please, please pass it along to myself or one of your deacons. And I'm proud of them for what they're doing by also staying in contact with the families in our church. Again, tonight, we're going to be in Revelation chapter 1, verse 9. I ask you, if you will, take your Bible and turn to Revelation chapter 1. We're going to read one verse. What we're going to be talking about tonight is isolation, how to make it through a quarantine. I know the stay-at-home order now has been in effect for a few weeks now, and a lot of people, I think as it draws out, are growing more and more nervous. What does the future look like? Not only for our country as a whole, but for churches in America. So tonight we're going to learn a little bit about John the Apostle, and we're going to learn how he spent time in isolation on the Isle of Patmos and what we can learn from that. This is really practical stuff that we're about to talk about and go through. And so I highly encourage you to take notes. Highly encourage you to start your own watch party, share the video as we work our way through God's Word with someone. We will be uploading this to YouTube, hopefully later on this evening. But again, thank you for joining in with us. Before we get started, let's go to the Lord in prayer and ask His blessing over our time. God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity to be together through Facebook Live and this technology. I pray, Holy Spirit, that you would be with every person that is listening. I pray you'd be with every person watching, that you would deal with each heart. You would grow us in our relationship to you. And God, I pray that you would use your word tonight to encourage your people. And so we ask this in Jesus' name, amen. Again, I welcome you tonight. I'm in a little different spot than usual. I'm here in the family dining room. So I just welcome you here with us here in Revelation chapter 1, verse 9. Again, we're talking about isolation. How in the world do we make it through this quarantine? I want to read Revelation chapter 1, verse 9. Mark this verse in your Bible if you never have. As we read it, you put a little asterisk by it, underline it. Very important verse. It says in the Revelation chapter 1, verse 9, I, John, who also am your brother and companion in tribulation, and in the kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was in the isle that is called Patmos, for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. What I want you to go ahead and do with your pen or pencil, if you don't mind doing this, underline a couple phrases that we see in the latter part of this verse. When you're studying God's word, you may hear a pastor or teacher say part A or part B of the verse. Part A means that we're speaking of the first part of that verse, part B, the latter. So what I want you to do is look at verse 9, look at part B, which is the latter part of that verse. John says, for the word of God, underline that phrase, and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. I read a Fox News article this week, and the article was entitled, Americans Are Lonelier Than Ever as a Result of the Coronavirus. What they did is they wrote this article around how lonely people have been since being in a stay-at-home quarantine order. A survey was conducted of over 1,000 Americans, and these 1,000 Americans were asked, respondents, to think about how the outbreak is affecting them. And it reveals that self-isolation has caused loneliness to hit new heights. 44% of a little over 1,000 people polled in America said that they are just downright lonely during this time. And with so much unpredictability that's going on in the world, 68% said they feel like everything is out of their control. Maybe that is you tonight. Maybe you're at home and you feel lonely. Maybe you watching the news and you feel like that, man, this world is just spiraling more and more out of control. Well, in the book of Revelation, it was given by Jesus Christ to John the Apostle. John and his brother James were called by Jesus to be fishers of men. What we read in the New Testament is that John traveled with Jesus during his ministry and was one of the chosen 12 apostles. We also understand that from John's life, what we read in the New Testament is that John was the only disciple that was present at Christ's crucifixion, and that John, during Jesus' earthly ministry, was extremely loyal to Jesus. Jesus loved John. Read John, you write this passage down, you go home later, or you can read it here at home now, read it there at home later, John 21, verse number 7. You see where even the other apostles, they saw the love that Jesus had for John. And so here John is in Revelation, and we understand in verse 9, he has been exiled to this Isle of Patmos. And John, again, was special to Jesus. Jesus, while hanging on the cross, he asked John to watch over his mother. When you fast forward into the book of Acts, we understand that John helped Peter heal folks in the name of Jesus and spread the gospel. Now in Acts chapter 12, 1 through 17, King Agrippa I, he attacked Christians and caused them to suffer outside of Jerusalem. And when this happened, John ended up in Ephesus. Now, there is some thought by theologians that he actually even pastored the church there at Ephesus for some time. But later on, there was persecution by the Roman emperor Domitian, and John was captured, and he was sentenced to this Isle of Patmos. And Patmos was a small, rocky, and barren area where criminals of Rome were sent to serve out their prison terms in harsh conditions. And so we get in our mind as we open up Revelation that John has been exiled to this place. He's under persecution and he is alone on this island and facing just dire straits and dire straits because of his faith. And here in Revelation verse 1 or chapter 1 verse 9, we understand and we see his situation. Now, the beloved disciple of Jesus in Revelation, when he receives this from Christ, he's isolated and he's alone. And one can ask the question, how could this be a part of God's plan? I want you that are listening to understand that God has a plan in the midst of this pandemic. That you may be at home and be lonely and be depressed and be discouraged, but God is up to something. God has a plan. Think about John for a second, and I think about Henry Blackaby. Henry Blackaby, and I quote, says, "We don't choose what we will do for God. He invites us to join him where he wants to involve us." If you go back to when John was called by Jesus to be a fisher of men, to be involved in his earthly ministry, only Jesus knew at that time that what he was inviting John to be a part of would eventually lead him to an isle called Patmos. Let me say, if you're listening and you're lonely and you're discouraged and you're trying to understand COVID-19, this pandemic and everything going on in the world, God is at work. If you have trusted in Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, friend, I'm encouraging you to continue to trust in the fact God is up to something. God is at work. When we think about John in this passage, by the language he uses, we know that John obviously knew why he was on that island. See, John knew that he was there not for John, but for Jesus. Now, notice in Revelation chapter 1, verse 9, John, with complete confidence, says, "For the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus, I am on this island." There is no language or hint of complaint that John is on this isle. We do not see in the language or hear when we read from this text that John is disappointed. He's saying, "God put me here." Let me say that if you're lonely and you're discouraged and you're like, "What is God up to?" we need to understand and learn from John. The language he uses in the middle of isolation is selfless and understands that God has a purpose for this moment in his life. So you've got to remember that John was in a less than ideal situation. Let me ask you tonight, are you in a less than ideal situation? See, many of you right now are in less than ideal situations. Everyone in America has been given a stay-at-home order unless you've been deemed essential personnel. You may be starting right now to go stir crazy. You know how I know that some of you are going stir crazy? Because as I go down through Facebook, I see your post. Believe it or not, I see, and the whole world sees, that's what Facebook is, your post. And I see folks in good fun, but then I also see folks that I know are really struggling. They're discouraged, and they're trying to make sense of everything that is going on. Maybe loneliness tonight is setting in. See, human beings were created to want other human interaction. Let's all remember, each of us, that we were created in the image of God, Genesis chapter 1 and verse number 27, and that God is a relational being. See, that trait, and being created in His image and being created in His likeness, makes us at our core relational beings. So here we are. How do we get through this quarantine? How do we overcome loneliness? What do we learn and understand from verse 9 of Revelation chapter number 1? Well, there's two observations from John's attitude. See, it's key, man. Attitude's the key. There's two observations from his attitude based on this language we see in this verse about his situation that we need to point out. The first observation is this, and this is important. Write this down. We hear God's word best without the distractions of life. It was absolutely no coincidence that John ended up on the Isle of Patmos in exile, in isolation. Friend, it is no coincidence that you are where you are tonight. I want you to hear very loud and clear, God sees you. He sees you exactly where you are tonight. We notice in Revelation 1, verse 9, you say, well, where's this observation from? He says in verse number 9, he says, I was in the isle that is called Patmos. I was there, first off, for the word of God. Mercy Me wrote a song several years ago now, and it is entitled, Word of God Speak. Let me just read these lyrics to you and listen. Word of God speak, would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know that you are in this place. Please let me stay and rest in your holiness. Word of God speak. There is a disorder, and it's a real disorder. It's called attention deficit disorder. I want to say that so often in my life, personally, I've had what I want to call AGD disorder. It's called attention to God disorder. Let me say, man, in America and all around the world, it is so easy as a follower of Christ to become distracted. But what we need in the middle of quarantine is the word of God to speak in our life. What we need in the midst of a pandemic is the word of God to speak. And we see where John has ended up in exile. John has ended up on the Isle of Patmos in this isolation, far away from friends and family, persecuted because of his faith. But I believe God put him there for a reason, to receive a word from God. So the first observation we understand is that we need to hear God's word, and we hear God's word best without the distractions of life. I want to encourage you, friends listening, get outside, take a walk, spend this time growing in your conversation with Almighty God, and then also spend this time being quiet, keeping your mouth shut, and letting God speak into you. The second observation that we make from verse number 9 is this. The observation is we see the test as His, Christ's, testimony. I want you to notice the language we see in Revelation chapter 1 in verse number 9. It says, and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. He says, I am on this island for not John's testimony, but for Jesus to testify of himself. Let that sink in for a minute, church. He's saying, I've got you, John, in isolation because there's some divine things that I want to teach you. Listen, friend, in the middle of COVID-19, in the middle of a pandemic, God still is speaking and God still is testifying about himself. This word testimony, we see it twice in chapter 1. We see it in verse 2, and we see it also in verse number 9. It's the same word in the original text. It means testifying, testifying of future events that only Christ has the divine knowledge of. You're sitting there, some of you tonight, scared to death about next week, scared to death about next month. Let me tell you something, as a child of the King, as a child of Jesus Christ, I've been adopted into His family, and now the Holy Spirit is with me. And that Holy Spirit, don't miss this, this Holy Spirit that lives within me is my comforter, is my guide, is the one wanting to lead me through next week, is the one wanting to lead me through next month. And so John, on this island in exile on Patmos, all alone, he gives us this word. Notice, John did not say it was John's own testimony. No, he said it was Jesus himself testimony, and Jesus had something to say. Let me say tonight, if you don't hear anything I say, Jesus has something to say to you. And he has something to say to you right smack dab in the middle of a pandemic. So follow me here. The test that John was facing was isolation and exile. And what that was going to result in was receiving Christ's plan for the future of the church. Man. The application for us is that we must have the understanding that God's desire is to reveal new things about Himself to you through your test. We must empty ourselves and be teachable with a willing attitude. I tell you, man, here is John, exiled to the Isle of Patmos, isolation, struggling, starving, and in the middle of his test, God gives him words for the future, for the end of the church and the world, and that we will live eternally with Jesus forever. Let me tell you something, church, you need to look up, stop putting your head down, stop being worried about everything going on around you, and start letting the Word of God speak in your life, and start understanding that God has a perfect will for you. Stop looking down, start looking up, because remember, Jesus walked out of that tomb. You're victorious tonight. You need to stop living as you've been defeated, because every single one of us are victorious in Jesus Christ, who have trusted in Him for our salvation. Don't give up. Don't back up. Don't give in, because we win, church. That's what John was given from Jesus, that we win. He is, as John was given, the bright and morning star. Wake up, church. Get your head up, because you are a child of the King. Wake up. Stop looking down and start looking up. And so we get down to the end and we say, and we ask this question again, well, how do we make it through a quarantine? I've already told you we need the Word of God to speak in our life. I've already told you that the test that we're in, Christ wants to reveal His will for our life through this test. And in the end, it's all about Him receiving the glory and not about you and me. So how do we make it through a quarantine? This is practical, man, practical stuff. Number one, do not let the events of COVID-19 distract you from God speaking in your life. Understand that God's eternal plan for the church is unchanged. You can't knock that train off its tracks. Man, we're still on track. The rapture of the church can happen at any moment. Every prophecy that needs to be fulfilled for Jesus to return and take His church home has been fulfilled. He can come before this video is over. The events that are to come, that spelled out to John while in isolation, church, they're still going to happen. He's still coming again. Wake up. Be praising Him. because you are a child of the King. Understand that God has a message for the world. The gospel is not quarantined. The second thing about how we make it through a quarantine, see the test that COVID-19 has brought into your life. Maybe it's schedule changes. Maybe you're listening tonight and you've lost your job. As an opportunity that Christ wants to use as an opportunity for Him to teach you and grow your relationship with Him. Third thing is this. Be flexible and slow down. God certainly slowed John down. He's on an island. How far could he really go? He was being persecuted for his faith. He had nowhere to run to. He had nowhere to hide. And while on that island, he received a word from God that lets us know, as Christ followers, God's future plans for the church and the world. I want to wrap it up tonight by saying this. Imagine what we miss by being so fast-paced. This is a time for us to be still and let God speak and let God, through this test, receive glory. Don't be distracted. Don't have attention to God disorder. See this as an opportunity for Him to teach you and grow you in your relationship with Him. Trust Him. Be flexible. Accept the slowdown. I'm thankful John did. God, we thank you for this day. May we realize that this life is about Jesus receiving glory. I pray, Holy Spirit, you would give the peace passes the understanding of humanity to those who were worried to death tonight. Those who may be lonely and struggling to just survive. May we love each other and continually support one another through this. We pray for a great awakening of the church across America. Help us not to be distracted. Help us to understand that this test is an opportunity to grow closer to you. Help us to be flexible and help us to slow down and let you be God. Thank you, God, for involving us in your eternal plan. Thank you for Jesus. We ask this in His name. Amen. Church, let me say I love y'all. Appreciate you guys very, very much. I hope you have a great night. Listen, Sunday at 11, we're going to be talking about thorns. We're going to be talking about struggling, battling our flesh. How do we get through battling our flesh and weaknesses each and every day that we live? Paul had a thorn in the flesh. Paul had a weakness. We're going to talk about and be practical on how do we handle that. I love y'all. Be praying about what is to come this Sunday. If you have any questions about tonight's message, feel free to message me. If you guys need anything, reach out to myself, reach out to one of your deacons. I'm thankful for Art. I'm thankful for Vern. I'm thankful for Eric. I'm thankful for Robert. I'm thankful for these guys. I'm thankful for their families and what they mean, how they're reaching out to folks. And I love y'all very much. Again, I hope you guys have a great night. Enjoy your families. Remember John. Remember we're going to get through this. And remember, church, we win. And we've won. I love y'all. Have a good night.